A Kiba backup is a Joomla component to help you backup, restore, and transfer your website. In this lesson, we will be installing a Kiba Backup Professional into our Joomla 3 website. To begin with, you'll need to subscribe to a Kiba Backup at akibabackup.com. When you've done that, go to the login and log in with your username and password. Now, if we go to the My link and click on My Subscriptions, we can see the subscription we've just purchased and a link to our download. Click on the download to download a Kiba Backup Professional to your computer. Once that's done, leave this page open as we'll need some information later and go to your Joomla website. A Kiba Backup Professional installs like any Joomla extension, so go to the Extensions menu and select Extensions Manager. Now, choose the file that you just downloaded to your computer and press Upload and Install. You'll see a success message like this, and we can now move on to the next stage. Go to the Components menu and select a Kiba Backup. We're now at the Configuration page. The configuration wizard will start. At this point, a Kiba Backup Professional is testing itself on your web server and configuring itself to make sure that it is working in the best possible way on your unique web server. Once this is complete, we can do our first backup. So let's click on Backup Now. A Kiba Backup stores a short description with every backup that it takes. By default, it uses today's time and date, and that's fine, but you can edit that if you want. You can also optionally add a comment, perhaps to state that this backup is performed before installing a new component or performing an upgrade. To perform the backup, just click on Backup Now. A Kiba Backup Professional is now backing up your website. It's important that you do not leave this page until the backup has completed. Once the backup is completed, we can go to our Manage Backups page, where we can see a list of all the backups that have taken place. Here we can see that the backup was taken today, its status was okay, and here is a link to download the file. Depending on your configuration, this may be multiple files. A backup kept on your web server is as good as keeping your spare keys inside your house. So it's essential that we now download the backup and keep it on our computer somewhere safe. To do that, simply click on the link, set OK, and save. Now that the backup has been downloaded to our computer, we can delete the backup from the web server. To do this, select the backup and press Delete Files. Note there is also a delete. Delete Files will simply delete the backup file, but leave a record that a backup took place. Delete will delete both the record that the backup took place and the file itself. I'm going to just choose Delete Files. We can now see that the record still exists, but the backup file itself has been removed from our web server. We're almost finished configuring a Kiba Backup Professional. Let's go back to the control panel, and we can see a message that we need to enter our download ID before a Kiba Backup Professional's update system will work. This is available on your subscription page on akibabackup.com. So let's go back to that page. Here is the download ID, and the ID itself is a long string of numbers and letters. So select it all and copy. Return to your Joomla website and paste it in. an Akiba Backup Professional is now configured to enable you to perform live updates when a new version of Akiba Backup Professional is released.